I will never hurt you. This is a future fake. A future fake is the use of a future event to control the now. And we as narcissists do this repeatedly. I want to marry you. Let's get married next year. I want to move in with you. I will always love you. I can't wait until we have a child together. I can't wait until we travel to Mauritius. Let's do that next year. I want to show you the sights of Rome. I will do it next week. I will repay you in a month's time. I'll bring it back to you tomorrow. So many uses of a future event to secure your control right now. And the uttering of the phrase, I will never hurt you, is but one of those future fakes. So easy to say, yet absolutely impossible for us to execute. These are the words which ought never need to be spoken. Someone who is healthy and has emotional empathy will not hurt the person that they love, care about, and cherish. Consequently, as I have observed, since they will not hurt that person and know that they will not do so, there is never any need to tell them that they won't do so. Why would you tell somebody something that you have no intention of doing? Of course, people who are not of our kind will trot out this sentence at some point, swept up in their love for their other half, and feeling the need to assert this, misguided, of course, by the narcissistic narrative. Those who are not of our kind will say this not because they will hurt you, but rather they are not entirely confident as their position with their other half, and that they empathically feel that they should provide some reassurance. And so they do, by saying this sentence. It still remains an empty comment, because even the non-narcissist doesn't know what the future will bring, but he or she is hugely unlikely to engage in issuing any kind of hurt towards the person that they love. Those who are truly secure have no need to say it at all and will not. But how do you discern between the well-intentioned but empty comment of the insecure non-narcissist and the future faking of our kind? All in good time. We tell you these words because it masks the fact that we ultimately are going to hurt you. And by telling you this, we're doing two things. One, using words once again rather than our actions to con you. We adopt this phrase because it sounds meaningful. It sounds honest and decent, the very things that you need to hear, because we are mirroring the fact that you are a person of meaning, of honesty and decency. And engaging in the self-delusion that our narcissism causes. By repeating that we will not hurt you, then this means that we aren't going to. We are not going to harm you. We are not the bad person. This, of course, then enables us to create the, in our view, unassailable position that you caused the hurt. We didn't, and we know we didn't, because we told you once upon a time that we would never hurt you. And because we said that and said it many times, then that must be true and valid. We have to say this because we want to ensure that you hear those things which will bind you to us. Of course, when this is said by the lesser or mid-range narcissist, they honestly believe it. They honestly don't think that they're going to hurt you. But they are empty words. Why? Because they're coming from a narcissist, and it is just a form of manipulation. Where these words are said by the greater or the ultra, in that moment, we believe that we won't hurt you, but we know that it will inevitably occur, because you will do something that deserves to be met by hurt. It is always your fault. We are faking what the future will bring, creating the illusion that is the golden period whereby you suffer no ill, experience no pain, and endure no hurt. We require you to find reassurance in those words, to allow their effect to wrap around you and make you believe them. We need you to buy into those words and accept that the future will be one of happiness, one that is pain-free, so you give us what we want now. Of course, what these words also do is add to the height of the pedestal from which you will inevitably tumble. Each promise of a golden future that lies ahead for you raises you that bit higher on the pedestal, so that when we do hurt you, and we will, your fall is all the harder. The contrast is greater, and accordingly your reaction to the hurt is intensified, and this gives us more control and more fuel. The negative fuel becomes provided in larger amounts, and is provided more often. Just what we need. But you said you would never hurt me, you declare through the tears. You bought into the dream based on this promise. You expected that we would deliver on this announcement of never doing anything to hurt you, so you could give your all to us, and open yourself up to us, wide open, exposed and vulnerable. Nobody wants to be hurt, and you never expect to be hurt by somebody who supposedly loves you and cares for you. These are words that should remain unspoken, and should you hear them said to you, you should take heed, for the reality is that these words are being said in order to influence and control. They are said or written purely to seduce you, to control you. They are issued to mask the fact that the issuer is one who does hurt, who has hurt, and will do so again. It is necessary to hurt you. It is necessary to do this to control you. It is necessary to draw on the negative fuel that hurt causes. You will be punished because you have hurt us. You have failed to deliver, and you will always fail to deliver, and thus the hurt will always be brought to bear upon you. By providing an assurance so easy to say with those seemingly earnest words, we con you into believing them. But on what truth do those lies rest? Where is the evidence to show that we will not hurt you? There is none. It is a future event, and therefore all that manifests is intent, and that is as concrete as the ether. It would be slightly more honest to state, I don't know what the future will bring. I may hurt you, I may not, we just don't know. Not very romantic, though, is it? Not something you want tattooed on your forearm, is it? Hardly the stuff of beating hearts, fluttering stomachs, and Hallmark cards. Far better to utilize the expectation of cherishing our soulmate, and tell our victim that we will never hurt them, fake them into thinking that the future is going to be wonderful, and have them sign up and submit. Should you ever hear these words, you should respond with, I think that you will. Then see what reaction you receive to your comment, because you will, where those words have been spoken to you by a narcissist, will challenge us. The response will be most telling, and is likely to provide you with confirmation of this future-faking red flag, or whether it has been issued by a well-meaning but harmless individual. The insecure, harmless individual assert they will not hurt you, but will ask, why do you think that? And then will concede, because of the ability to see in grey, that they could actually hurt you, although they would never intend to, and they might do so inadvertently. Our kind will be adamant that we will never, ever hurt you. And such is the conviction by which we say this, because we are feeling challenged and we need to assert our control over you, albeit since it is during seduction we can't do so in a malign way, such is the way whereby we reject any suggestion whatsoever that this will happen, because we, of course, operate in absolutes, it's either black or it's white, there is no maybe, there is no grey, then this will be the indicator that this is the future-faking comment of our kind. I'm H.G. Tudor. Thank you for listening.